Let's go, Mama.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Mama.
Hey, Mommy. What's up, Mama?
What's going on, guys? Tyson Anderson, Mr. Hammerdown. Listen, I'm out here with Miss Letty. I've got a little bit of allergies. Excuse me. Pardon me. But I'm out here with this little female out of Pete. Me and Anderson's Black Bart and Southwood's Kylie. It's been a while since I've actually came on to show you guys what this little female looks like. I've actually got the three out of Thunder, Kiss Black Thunder, and Full Count Black Betty. And this female is going to be one of the five that's going to be my pack for this 2022 to 2023 hunting season. As you can see, for those that know Anderson's Black Bart, you can see the phenotype bursting through the seams right there. So as some guys know, the phenotype traits, or gene, is the observable traits of a dog, right? Let's go, Mama. Hunt him up, 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 hunt him up. Hunt him up, Mama, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up. So it's getting thicker and thicker out here. And this is my same little spot I come to. I've came to some different spots just here lately to see how she responds. Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up. Just to see how she responds.
Hey, Mommy. What's your dog, Mom? Get in there.
Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up. Hunt him up, Mama, that's him. Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up.
Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up.
Haven't been over here in a while. I've taken the weeks off because I've been training and working on obedience more than anything. And that's just that handling side of it, right? Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up. Doesn't take a dog long to remember where they came from, though, and what it is that you're trying to get them to do. Only thing you have to do is do it. Pay attention to detail. Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up. For you, those of you guys that know how Anderson's Black Bart look. Hey, Letty, right here, right here. Hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up, hunt him up.
What's your mama?
Something's definitely probably been through here wild, and she's never smelt that before, so she's probably like, what in the world is this?
What's your mama?
Hunt him up. See, before she just burst through the seams, right? Now she's using her nose a whole lot more. Still not started. She's still a totally unstarted dog, right? The difference is, hunt him up. Hunt him up, Mama. Hunt him up. 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 Find him. Find him. Look for him, Mama. Find him. The difference is that her mind's maturing a whole lot more. She's paying attention to detail right now a whole lot more. Now, this is probably only about a half an acre of little brush and stuff. You know, that's all this is. But the good thing about it is, you don't need a whole lot if you're not trying to start the dog. If you're just trying to get basic movement going, see how she just loosens up a little bit. If you're just trying to get basic movements and motion going, which is all I'm trying to do, is to get like a burst through the seams type of motion going. If you're trying to get that motion going, you don't need much. You don't need a little bit of nothing, just a little corner. Literally, you don't need anything. You know, I just have this little part right here. I mean, I've got a lot of places, but this is right here, relatively close to the house. I can just walk over here at any time and just mess with the dogs, but or the puppies. But you just have to worry about, pay attention to the four-wheelers and stuff like that, because we are in the country, obviously, right? It's just the country. So, hunt him up, 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 hunt him up. Letty, right here, right here, right here, right here, right here.
Get Mama, get Mommy.
What's that? What is that? What's that? What's that? What's that?
What's that?
I love paying attention to dogs in their natural habitat. Those are, if they're hunting dogs, they're working dogs, their natural habitat is bad in the working field. Those dogs are to work. They're to be outside, moving, making that motion. She's taking on a leaner body right now, so that observable trait of the Birch Lake, of a mixture of the New York Nick, and you know, and whatnot, you see it in there. You can see it visually. You can see it clearly. You know.
What's your mama?
Hunt him up. She runs herself lean like that. I don't keep her lean like that. I, you know, give a good bit of food to her, but she's so athletic. She's always doing and moving and going. So, I mean, this little female, she burns a lot of calories. You know, for me, I don't like my puppies hog fat anyway. Guys do. I keep some puppy fat on there, but, you know, it's getting ready to warm up. This female right here is kept inside the house, you know, in the back room. So, I mean, you know, I just, she's not exposed to as many parasites and other things that most dogs would be exposed to, you know? And this video really does her zero justice, because she's a built little female. I mean, she really is. If you've seen the pictures of her, when she gets serious and she wants to, you know, pose for the camera, she's a great looking gyp, you know? Extremely leggy. I'm getting her acclimated, and so acclimated, this is my goal anyway, right? My goal is to get this puppy so acclimated to the outdoors with as little of secondary influence and persuasion needed. My goal as the trainer and the facilitator of her gifts, her talents, her personality, you know, her everything, is to make sure that I caretake and watch over that, and I guide her, I aim her in the direction that I believe her fate says, hey, this is the direction, you know, this is for you right here, this is what we got for you. But it's key that I do that as naturally as possible. In the bird dog world, they have something called natural retrievers. Dogs are just, you know, and beagles too, but they can do it. But in this sense, we're talking about the bird dogs and how they, you know, have a decoy or something, or, you know, a remote or whatever. And that dog has no problem. Let's go, Liddy. That dog has no problem of picking it up and bringing it on, right? And they do that often with that dog if that's what that dog is doing, because they want that dog to know, hey, look, good job. That's what I want you to do. This is what I want you to do, you know? Now she's starting to loosen up a whole lot more to get back to her normal flow. She hasn't been out here in a week, but I've been working on obedience. Maybe a week and a half. But you see how she flow? You see how she goes through it now? She's growling going through it. And she's attacking everything that's through there, right? You see her chin and stuff. She's loosening up. That's why I said we just stay here, keep recording, you'll catch her loosen up. Now she's displaying all of how Pete was, definitely that same little burst. Good girl, mama. Hunt him up. Hunt him up. Get her to do that same thing. Hunt him up. Find him, lady. Good girl. Hunt him up. Find him. Find him, lady. Find him. Hunt him up.
Good girl, mama.
Hunt him up.
Good girl.
All of her motions are very sporadic. She really went all out in this. Even at her age right now, she can run the fire out of rabbit. I guarantee it.
Good girl, mama.
This dog now is 4 months old. She was born November 24th. I pray I'm saying that correctly, but I'm almost positive. 2 days after my birthday, I'm pretty sure it's November 24th. And we have big plans, big plans for this little female. Big plans. She's a good looking little bitch. I come from a bulldog world, guys. So I originally had the true American pit bull terrier. And some guys are biased and some would shut the channel off because of me saying that, but I learned a lot from that genre of dog, as well as the game, you know, chickens, game cops. I learned a lot from those dogs. Learned a lot from all of it. And I'm grateful. I'm earnestly grateful. You know, I can't be more proud of my roots, of my heritage, and of my pedigree than to be able to say and admit openly what I just said. Hunt him up. Find him, Letty. Why? Because it grew me in so many different ways and so many different avenues and opened my mind to so many different currents. I would have never been able to embrace that kind of, you know, array of just difference, you know, in itself. So many different ways and methods and, you know, man, figurations to try and figure out the formula for the total dog. Huge shout out to Mr. Chad Castle. And some guys will say, man, why do you do that? Why are you looking to name drop? Not looking to name drop. These are just people of character and strong integrity. We are in no shape, form, or fashion in any kind of dealings. But I just, I'm so grateful for guys like this. I just want to throw guys' names out there that have been effective and been accountable to the relationship of myself and Anderson's Beagles, and at least the breeding part and program of what we're, you know, trying to do. And that is myself and I. And that is put the best of the best on the ground. He actually got a chance to get one of the pups, a female 15-inch bitches out of Field Champion, or Little Pack Rabbit Champion, humorously enough, and Field Champion, Howard's Bandit. And man, just one heck of a dog. Just one heck of a dog. And I think about that. Think about my legacy, like I said, my pedigree in all of this. And I'm just, you know, I'm floored. I'm flabbergasted. You know, I'm just side swiped 225 degrees. Because, you know, you can be so different but the same. And just because I run what I run or you run what you run doesn't mean that we don't have to get along. We can't like each other. It's just a mutual respect. And I think the sooner we figure that out about dogs, and we learned that fast about that in bulldogs, what we call American Pit Bull Terriers, but I'm grateful for that of the lesson I can bring over, the transferable lesson I can bring over for that of the bulldog over into the beagles, because it's something that you got under control quickly. You know, these dogs are in combat, and you know, owners of dogs in combat can, you know, things can take a left. But so grateful. Letty, here. Get this pup back in here. Good girl, mama. Hunt him up. Find him in here. He in here. Look for him. He in here. Find him, mama. You didn't find him. That's the girl. Good girl, mama. Good girl, 3 months old. Find him. Look for him. Find him. Good girl. Find him. I put my mind back in time where I remember having bulldogs and being able to work a puppy, a young puppy on a hide. And that is a pole, a spring pole with a deer hide or some kind of hide animal carcass on it. And nine times out of ten, it's a deer hide. You know, it can be a cloth, a rag, whatever, suspended by a spring and a good sized rope, you know. And I think about it, working that high with the dogs. One in particular, I had a female named, by the name of Sugar. She loved to do what you call work. And in learning how a dog does or does not love or like the initiation of work or anything affiliated or associated with something that could be categorized as work, you know, if it loved it, you go with it. If it never had any sign of quitting in it, you go with it. But if it had the sign of quitting in it, right here, lady, then you got rid of it. You excommunicate that had the sign of quitting. Give up. No guts, no drive. You got rid of it. I know, mama.
Hey, girl, mama.
Hey, girl. It's a new terrain tour. And this stuff is going up a little bit. And I probably won't go too deep in this because, you know, it's starting to warm up and you got to be careful around those pine needles, guys. I know my thoughts sound like they're switching in and out, but I'm paying attention to everything around me. This is the time of the year that snakes do get to moving, especially in stuff like this. And dogs that have that root up type of, you know, go through the little stuff, you know, they'll be the ones usually near the pine or wood piles to get bit, you know, little brush piles and stuff like that to get bit. And you know, you just have to be very alert and aware to your surroundings at all times. Coyotes, anything, bobcats, we have that here, those here, you know. This is one leggy little gyp right here. I mean, one leggy little gyp.
What's your mommy? What's your mommy?
She looks a lot like the Spike dogs, that Southwood Spike. But you can see that piece of socket tubing to me in there. I think you can. Look how fire this little gyp is.
What's your mommy? What's your mommy? What's your mommy? Woo, woo. What's your mama?
What's your
mommy? What's your mommy? What's
your? She's always moving.
Hey there, mama.
You coming to give me love? Come on, mama, let's get to work. Right here. She got me just ready to work, man. Right here, mama. Hey, go right here. Right here, mama, right here. Right here, hunt him up. Right here, hunt him up. Find him, see, all you're trying to do is spark that mind. You want to spark the mind. You don't want to take over the mind. You just want to spark it. Boom. Give it that spark. Bam. Boom. And I know you guys thought I forgot about it, but in that comparison of that dog working that hide, I look at that go get it mentality, that I gotta have it mentality, that I want to play with it, I want to bite on it, I want to shake it mentality, I want to work its mentality. You can see that in the bulldog, and I see that a lot in her. Hey, lady, hey, mama.
What's your mama? What's your mommy?
Hunt him up.
Come on, mama.
Hi, mama. Hi, mama. Every day is a lesson.
Hey, mommy. What's your mommy?
Yeah. Every day is a lesson, and you just thank God for the opportunity to teach it or to learn it. So it's a dual lesson between the two of you guys. I get a chance to see so many characteristics of this dog unfold daily. It's unbelievable. I love it. What are you doing? Oh, you been around here? What are you doing, mama?
What's
your little baby right there, guys? It's a baby.
What's your mommy? What's your mom? What's your mommy? What's your mom? Hey, mama.
Hey, lady. She's built just like her dad. That lanky, leggy, goofy type of, got to come into it. I know she'll be, probably a 14 3/4 inch little bitch. But that's all I'm needing. Down here on these low southern cottontails, she hates that collar. These southern cottontails and these swampers, you need a leggy dog. And I love a black and tan with white socks. I love a straight leg dog. I love a long, lanky dog, She's lanky, she's leggy, she's all of that. And she knows how to hold her own. She's a good looking Jip, I tell you. This little Jip is going nowheres. She's gonna stay in the camp. This is again by Anderson's Black Bart, which is by Field Champion Burst Lake Pretty Boy 2 with Anderson's Pretty Girl Rock. And AKA Mr. Pete. Which we're going to have another cross coming out of him very soon. Two coming out of him very soon. Just stay tuned for that. Why do you got a bite? I mean, full of fire, man. That's what he threw me here. So we'll see. Oh, his mother, I'm sorry. Southwoods, this female's mother, Southwoods Kylie. The double spike bitch. He's out of Field Champion Cooper Lake Cowboy, who was right out of spike, bred back to Southwoods Bala. Of course, you guys know that female that won the nationals for Jake. Congratulations to him again on that. They say dominated female, never seen a run, but I know the guys that's had the dogs that come down the pipeline, and the one I don't know, I know of very well. And when you see a person prove a female line, a bitch line, then you got to sort of go with the flow of that if it's in the same vicinity, of what you're looking for, what you're after, if you know what you're after, right? What I do is I just bring what I know or seem to know or think that I know is working. I bring that on and I keep that in the vicinity of what I've got. And I add that. So this female here is one of the female, the five, that you guys will see with Anderson's Beagles throughout this entire gun season. This female is not started. You've seen how small her teeth is, she's a baby, but she's going to be one of the five in the pack. The other three will be Kiss Black Thunder and Full Count Black Betty's offspring and litter. So, those are three females, big black and tan females. I'll put them on here very soon. I wanted them to get up at least to about 5, 6 weeks old, 7 weeks old before I really showed them, because I'm going to put them on the ground out here in the same, doing the same concept with those dogs, but it'll be individually. I will bring two at a time, maybe sometimes three, but I don't like to work a lot of puppies together, even though they're puppies. I like to spend that individual time on there with those dogs. Every now and again, I'll bring two dogs out like I did her and her sister, and I did her brother. But I don't make that an all-the-time thing, I want that dog to feel me one-on-one, my energy. Letty. I want them to, that's what I want. Come on, mama. Let's go, Nana. in that regard, I can't wait to see how it all comes together. I want you guys to be along the journey with me to see how it all comes together. I'm building this gun dog pack right now from scratch, literally, you know, just like it's pups, you know. And I'm walking you through the process of what it took to get here and what it takes to get there, you know. So if you stay tuned, you'll see the development. I'll even down to the breeding. If everything works and goes according to plan, she goes through the ringers and past the tests, you know. Hey, we'll see how long that back end is. The body of this little dog is unbelievable. Just like a little whippet. Strong hindquarters, front legs, good ear, good bite. You can have a block of the muzzle if I wanted to be, you know, critical. But, you know, it is what it is. You can square that muzzle off anytime. But those feet are tight. That gait is straight. It's not a really long the legs are. I wish she would just hold up for a minute. Hold on, mama. Hold on. Just to show you. Ay, 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 ay. She's very straight. And got those big old ears on her. Those high socks. And she about got me pretty good. Sure enough, my camera doesn't want to focus in, but inside of my hand pretty good too. Anyway, but I love it. I'm telling you, the deeper it goes, it's like it's, whoa! You know, it hissed into the blood. I really enjoy it, man. I tell you something about it. Something about bringing on dogs, but you guys stay tuned because listen, I want you guys to walk through the developmental stages as we progress. Right here, lady, let's go. Right here. As we progress and show you what it took me to get those dogs to that place and get them to be able to be bred, to be evaluated in the breeding program, trial world, which is the competition world, no matter the registry or format or formation. I want to be able to show you that, and that's what my plan is. So as you guys stay tuned, right here, lady, right here. As you guys stay tuned, you're going to see how I bring on a pack. And then if you want to say it, you can see how I want to bring on a pack of dogs that you'll be able to make foundation dogs or, you know, cross back in to create foundation or spin off of to make, you know, hybrid vigor dogs and all of that stuff. I'm going to show you all for these five for this hunting season and others. But, you know, here you're getting to see this from scratch. So stay tuned, guys. Stay on the lookout for parts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't know what number we're on. I don't know what number we're on, but stay on the lookout of all of that. And I'm telling you guys, it's going to be very interesting. Very, very interesting. So stay tuned. Until next time, guys, we're going to get into a little bit more of this, at least for another 30, 45 minutes, because we might actually jump a little rabbit out of here. And I want to see that. Hunt him up. I want to see that, so. Hunt him up. Tyson Anderson. Mr. Hammerdown. We'll see ya. When we see ya. Let's go, mama. Right here, mama. That's when all the conditions are right for a good time. I need a good time. Yeah, I've been working all week and I'm tired. I don't want to sleep and I want to have fun. It's time for a good time. I cash my check, clean my truck, put on my hat, forgot about work. Sun going down, head across town, pick up my baby and turn it around. Good time.